Hey guys, it's Raspberry Jam Gaming here, and today we're going to be playing Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker again. We're back where we started again. Well, you probably saw me going back to the menu, I guess. But we're getting another, a thing that can allow us to see enemy health bars, which is pretty cool. But I need this majority lead to get those bells. So we're just facing these mummy looking things. It's a little bit, you don't want to scoop. totally forgot I was low in health too. Off, you can snipe him. I'm a really good schnooper. Is that it? Did I do it? Okay. Oh, this is where we get the good stuff. Now we carry on with the episode. Oh, yes, the hero's charm. Yeah, the hero's charm. Totally forgot about it. Look at that. I got it on, guys. That's pretty cool, ain't it? Oh, what is it? Nice fish. How many of those do you have? I suppose it has come to me to speak to you about the knight's chest. The knight's chest. It is the symbol of a courageous knight. But not just anyone can gather them. No, it takes a soul who possesses not only the power but wisdom and courage as well. Any courageous soul who gathers 10 of them. I gathered 30 of them. Both my brother and I dreamt of learning the technique in our youth. We worked so hard to collect these crests. But it took many long years and adventures beyond count before we even approached finding 10 of them, and we both grew old. It appears you have enough might to learn the technique now. Perhaps just... God, I restarted my Wind Waker playthrough simply because I wanted that spin attack. The thing is, now that I learned that you only need 10, no, the thing is, I researched it, and some guy in an article said you needed 30. So I was like, okay, that's legit. So I'm going to get 30 of them. But now, you don't need that. What? So I went through all of that work just to, for them, him to tell me that I need 10. Oh my god. Well, this was like 2 years ago, I think. Build up power and release it. What the hell? You learned the hurricane spoon! You did it. You mastered the hurricane spin. At last you have made our long dream come true. Those tears, they won't stop. I thought tears dried up a long time ago. There is nothing left for me to teach you. I am certain now that you will save your sister Aro. Technically I already did that. But if you didn't know, well, okay. What do I feel now? It just feels, yeah. Yeah! Oh, there's a hole right here. Ah! Oh! Oh, those are all those boss ones. I think I've had enough fighting for one day. Bloody hell. I heard someone talking about, like, him not feeling that upgrade, which is kind of technically not a good thing, because people want to see progression. That's a key thing. Like, progression through the story, yeah, is important, but they want to see how you build, how you grow throughout the game. Like, I've been playing since bloody, what, May? June? No, yeah, June. I remember, because I looked it up. How do you look back at the show? We can probably finish this off without any hesitation. Oh, I should try the Ultra Spin attack. I really should. It leaves you wide open. Oh yeah, gotta kill that. I was gonna say, what? What's going on? I thought those enemies didn't count. I was actually generally so worried, but what do I do? Yeah. Look, two of them. Wow. How useless do I? Don't just give them to me. Don't give them to me like I care now. Wow, how pathetic. By the way, if you're struggling with the what's it called? With the boss fights in these temples, like mini temples or boss fights, whatever. You can hit the you can grab one of their swords and hit the pillars, and you get hearts. Five more. Let's do it. I can probably get the five in the next episode. Well, anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this episode, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.